In today's video, I'm gonna teach you how I digitize this deer head on the Design Doodler. Watch until the end to learn all of the tips and tricks that we use to create this design. Let's go. What's up, Legacy family? Welcome back to another video. And like always, this channel is supported by those of you who have purchased the Doodler app, our designs club, and our Digitizing Made Easy education. So thank you so much for your support, and the links to those products will be available in the description. Now, I didn't actually draw this image. I wish I did, but I'm not that skilled. I actually got this image from the British Library source. It is a public domain image that you guys can find in raw pixel. They have this image as well as many more, so if you guys want to digitize this for yourself, go check it out over there. And the reason why I chose a deer, well, I mean, after all, this is the deer's embroidery legacy. So let's go. We're gonna be opening up the Design Doodler, and if you guys have never used this application before, I highly suggest you click on this video up here, because John Deere himself gives you a full walkthrough on how to utilize the program. So I'm gonna open up the image, and to open an image, you simply click this little button down here. I'm gonna click on photo library, and we're gonna be importing the deer head. Awesome. Now down here you can enable or disable the image. Up here you have the hoop, which is the one that I'm going to use to size up the image. So I'm going to enable that image, and I will click on the select tool so that I can modify the image. And I'm gonna click on one of these points just so that I can resize it. Like always, this hoop is 100 by 100 millimeters. So it fits my 4 by 4 inch hoop. That is what I like. And now I'm just gonna make sure that maybe the design is around 3 inches or so. And if you guys wanna change the opacity to the image, if you click on this button right here, it brings up the properties window. And under that, you can make the opacity go down, go up, depending on what you prefer. I like to keep it around 50%. That's one of the beauties of this app. Now, I don't really need to move it anymore, so I'm gonna disable that, and I'm going to press the zoom tool to go in a little bit like that. I can press the hand tool if I wanna move around, and I'm gonna click the ruler tool if I wanna see how tall this design is. It is 73 millimeters by 74.5 millimeters. I don't know exactly the difference between millimeters and inches, but you know, it's a pretty good estimate. So, and over here we have the tool on how we can stitch. So let me show you that really quickly. I will be using the single stitch tool. That is the one that if you click on it, it's pretty much like a center run or like a single stitch. But there are other options. So for example, if you want to do the fill stitch, that's the one that you would use here. And if you want to use something that's called like a steel or like a satin or zigzag stitch, then you would click on that one. But for now, we're simply going to be utilizing the single stitch. Now here you can change the pretty much the distance between each point. I think I'm going to leave it at that one. And over here you have different shapes that you can use for that tool. I'm just going to leave it at the free tool. So like that. If you want to zoom out, you can click 1:1, 1:3 ratio, and 1:6 to really zoom in. The way I like to do it is I just leave it at 1:1, and then I use the zoom tool right here to go in a little bit more in detail. Awesome. So I'm gonna leave it at that. Also, I wanna thank John Deere for sending me the hand glove. That way, whenever I'm sketching now, it no longer recognizes my hand, which is awesome, because you guys saw in the last video, it kept recognizing it a little bit. So this way I can actually draw, rest my hand, and not have to worry about it at all. So thank you, John Deere. It's really awesome. For this design, I have one singular goal, and that's obviously besides making it look aesthetic, but that is that I wanna try to avoid to create stitches. So let's say, for example, I'm gonna start here. I don't want to start the next one here, then the next one here, then the next one here, and so on. Okay, we want to create a design where we're pretty much creating, like, if we're following one single thread from the beginning to the end of the design. Now, why is that? It's because if you can see this little line right here, I'm gonna zoom in. This is where your machine is either going to jump or trim or cut, and that is going to add a lot of time and trimming onto your embroidery. And that is something that you want to avoid if you want to have fast embroidery, which we all do, okay? So I'm gonna grab all of them. I'm going to delete. I'm pretty much going to start. So let's say I'm gonna do the hairs right here, and you can see that the end is right there. So I will continue the next one right there. And if you have to let go, that's no problem. Just keep going to the next one. That way it'll never really go anywhere. So it's okay. We can just continue from there. We can continue from here and so on, so forth. Okay, guys, so that is our goal with creating this design. I'm going to delete this by pressing X and we can get started. Awesome. So I'm gonna zoom in a little bit. And there really is no like specific way to get started. So I will just start right here down on the neckline. We're gonna go up and down to try and replicate those hairs, those hair fibers, and try and almost have the motion that they have. So going up and down, I'm gonna end it right there. I'm gonna go to the next one up and down. Right here, because it is a little thicker, I will be adding just a couple more. And over here, because it's a little more thinner on the hair, I'm going to try and spread out the stitches that I'm doing just a tiny bit, something like that. Now at the top right, you do have the 3D. So I'm enabling or disabling the 3D. I will keep it disabled if I'm moving my hand just so that the program doesn't lag. But if I'm not moving it, then I can enable the 3D, no problem. So let's go down here. And this one, because it is the edge outline, I'm just gonna do kind of like a zigzag type of motion there, almost like if I'm drawing, which is, I think, is the whole point of this program, is that you're supposed to feel like you're sketching on an iPad, and that goes onto the actual embroidery machine, which is just so awesome. So again, I'm almost just like sketching these little areas like so. Let's create something here. Let's bring it all the way around because I want to finish this area. Remember, we're pretending like we're simply working with one single piece of thread, which in reality, we are in real life. When it comes to embroidery, you start with one thread and you end with one thread. It's just that that thread sometimes gets cut, sometimes jumps, and that's what takes a lot of time in your embroidery, is having to do all of those things. So by me trying to do a single stitch and trying to keep it from the start to the end, I am avoiding all of those issues, okay? So that was pretty good. I think I'm gonna continue here and maybe just spread it out a little bit more like that. Awesome. Something like this. Let's go inside this area right here. I honestly have yet to test really what the appropriate amount of times to go back and forth is. So in a way, it's pretty cool to test this out to see how I'm doing a couple of zigzags here and there, a little bit more than others, and doing some overlapping on the single stitch. We're gonna find out once we embroider if it's a little too much, if it's too little, what we can do. That is the beauty of testing these things out. So over here, I'm just simply going around doing all of these little sections that I see from the deer. So I'm just trying to finish this hair area right here. Looks awesome. And let's keep going. Let's finish actually at the bottom over here. I'm just following the hairs, honestly. I'm not really doing anything crazy special. I'm just trying to follow. Oh, I'm going a little bit back. That's cool, no problem. And I'm going to try to unite this area. And because I remember that this area is a little more solid, I'm gonna go back one more time just with that extra hair. If you click on this eye thing right here, you can actually enable or disable what it looks like so far. And if I'm disabling this, it kind of looks like a donkey, not so much like a deer, but we have yet to add the antler. So hopefully that's going to fix it right away. So let's add this part of the ear. Like always, I'm just doing a zigzag. I'm doing a back and forth just to fill that part. I will end it there. Awesome. We're gonna do a couple times. And maybe for this part right here, we're gonna do almost like a sketch. I don't really like that one. So I'm just gonna rewind and we can start again. No problem. You can click the rewind button and then you just go back to the last placement that you did. That's why it's kind of cool to be able to let go in this design. That way you don't have to worry about like, oh, if I didn't let go, now my whole design is erased and I have to start all over again. None of that. So I'm gonna press 1-1. I'm gonna press the zoom tool. Let's see what that looks like 3D. Looks pretty cool. And now I'm curious to see how this is going to look on the embroidery. Is it gonna be a little too much? Is it not gonna be too much? We're gonna find out. So again, I'm gonna zoom in. I'm going to take out the 3D, enable the image. Awesome, let's move over here. And I think we can finally start doing the antler in a second. So let me just finish this area right here. Cool. and continuing that dot. Want to make sure that I'm finishing and continuing without one single stitch, okay? That is my whole goal of this design, besides making it look cool. Okay, 3D looks awesome. Let's go to this one right here. I'm just going to move my hand so that I can go over here. Let's go around this area. I'm trying to be as accurate as possible, but in reality, I mean, it is definitely like that style of a sketch. So it's okay if I go outside the line a little bit. We're here to have fun, create some awesome designs. So don't worry so much if it isn't perfect. So again, if I don't like it, I can simply rewind like so. And I'll just go back and forth one more time like that. 3D again. Cool. Maybe I'll add one more line like so. Awesome. And let's continue to the next area. So I'm just going to add a couple of shading right there. Let's make the next little antler part right here. Bring it all the way down like so. And we're going to shade this area. And by shading is literally just going back and forth. So you can see I'm going back and forth. I'm shading. I'm doing the zigzag. And these little areas, I'm just gonna give a little bit more space, you know, not make it look so crazy. Let's go to this next one. 1, 2, something like that. Super, super simple. Take out the 3D if I'm gonna move around. So like I said, I'm just going around. This one actually doesn't have that many shadows. So I'm only gonna add like a lot of like overlap just in this little area right here. And for the rest, I'm kind of going to go like a couple of times back and forth, but that's it. Nothing too crazy. Okay, let's go to the next one. Just create this other one right here. Same thing, super quickly. We're going to do a bit of an outline by going back and forth a couple times. And this one right here, same thing. The shadow seems to be on the left side, so that's why we're going to overlap a couple more times than the other ones. I'll just go around one more time and we can keep going. I didn't even let go. I just kept going. Let's return that right there. And then what we can even do is, you know what? Let's use this one to go back one more time to go back here. That way it has more of that solid line. Awesome. Now let's connect it by going down here. And should we finish this area? Let's finish this area. Why not? So I'll go around here. Awesome. One more time like so. And let's do this area over here. Like I said, guys, we're experimenting right now with these shadows, with these outlines that we're doing. We're going to find out once we embroider it if it's going to look a little bit too dense or not. This is part of the fun, and you will experiment with your designs. This is why practice makes perfect, because the more you practice creating designs like this, the better you will get at how you create your sketches. Okay, so here I'm just going to go back and forth quite a few times. I don't know how many times exactly I'm doing it. I feel like I should count just so I know in the future how many I should do, but I'm pretty happy with that and I will end it right there. Let me disable the image, move around here. Oh, 1 to 1. Move around there, zoom in a little. Wow, I love how it looks like a deer. And if we turn it on, looks like a pretty cool deer. So turn it off again, turn on the image, and let's go to the next one. So we're gonna go around, 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 like so. I'm gonna finish it there, and what I'll do is I'm just gonna do a bunch of zigzags right here, like so, just to add that shadow look to it. Oh yeah, that's pretty cool. Go back around, and we can continue to the next one. I'm gonna let go just so in case I have to rewind, maybe just so I don't like, you know, have to go back all the way, create a couple of those. And here, same thing, we're just gonna do a couple of sketches, like so. Let's bring it back and forth a couple of times here. One more time, and maybe I'll do like a really quick outline again. Let me do that really quickly like that. Define this area one more time. I think this is pretty good. Let's move it around back to the beginning. Let's delete the image, or not delete it, but put it away. Let me enable the 3D, and boom, we have a pretty cool deer head. All right, I think this looks pretty awesome. I really like the way it looks. By the way, guys, whenever you're working on any of these designs, just make sure to click the save. I'm gonna call it Deer Head 1, and I'm going to click okay. Now that it's safe, I'm gonna make sure, you know, just that it's all good. And then I'm gonna show you really quickly how we can send it to the Windows program so that we can export it. Let's just see what the slow redraw looks like really quickly. I'm gonna click on the three buttons all the way at the bottom, and I'm gonna click slow redraw, and I'm gonna press play. So just disabling the 3D, remember, because on the iPad, it kind of like slows down just a little bit. You can see, it's doing that. You can see how it's doing all of those tiny little points all in one thing. Awesome. I like this a lot. I'm so excited. I can't wait to embroider this. I'm just gonna press stop, take it away because I don't need the slow redraw. Oh, and one more thing is we're gonna go onto layers, and under layers, you can see that all of the layers that we made are here. Now what we're gonna do is we're going to select all of the layers and we're going to click branch. That is going to make sure that this design is pretty much branching, so there is no way that it can actually like jump anywhere. Instead, it's going to make the design all in one stitch from start to end, save you a lot of time with embroidering, and well, it's gonna look really, really nice. So now we're gonna save again, Deer Head 2, just because it's the new update. I'm gonna press okay, and now my design is saved. Now the last thing I'm gonna do is click files, and then right here you will see Deer Head. So if you go to on my iPad, then you go into Design Doodler right here. I'm gonna open this up. You should see all of your saved files right here. I have Deer Head 2, so I'm gonna hold, click on it, and I'm gonna click share. Now, once you click share, you can pretty much select whatever you prefer. It can be your Google Drive, it can be your email. Just send it to yourself so that you can open it on your Windows computer and export to the file that you'd like. So for example, it might be PAS for you, whereas for me, it's DST. I'm over here on my Windows computer and I've already downloaded the file from my email. I'm simply going to click the open. So under open, I will now scroll down wherever I saved it. And for me, it was just simply on desktop. I will double click to open the image, and you can see that the design is now here. You can even enable or disable the 3D, and if you click the three dots, you can view the slow redraw by turning it on or off. And this is really awesome because on PC, since they're a lot faster, you can actually go through the 3D no problem. The only thing about the iPad is that it is a little slower, so that's where I gotta give it to the PC. Now that it's ready, it's all good to go. We're simply going to export it. So like I said, we're gonna click on Save As, and you're going to export it to the embroidery machine that works for you. For example, for me, like I said, it was DST, but for you, it might be PES or JEF. So choose the one that works for you. Let's select DST right here, so Tajima DST, and I'm simply gonna save it on the desktop. So I click save, give it a couple seconds, and now the file is ready. I can see it right here. All you gotta do is put this on a USB and it's ready to be embroidered. And this is what the result looks like. I'm pretty happy with it, but I decided to go back and change some settings because I thought it was just a little bit too much. So what I did is I went back and on the iPad, I rewinded before I decided to branch them together. So now the design is no longer branched, and I went under the settings after highlighting everything, and I changed the stitch spacing from 3 millimeters to 4 millimeters. Then it reduced the stitch count all the way from 11,000 stitches to 2,000, and this is the result of that design. Now this looks amazing. I am so happy with the result of this design. Here is the before and here's the after. So like I said, guys, please experiment with your own creations. Don't be afraid to go back and change some settings. Remember to save your projects so you can always create a new version of what you do. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed learning how to create this design. The Design Doodler is available in the link in the description. So go click that link and I'll see you guys on the next one. Bye-bye, Legacy Family.